Hi, thank you for coming to Dan Potter Yoga. I'm Dan Potter, if you've been here before. So honored you're coming back, thank you. Today we're gonna do a mostly silent yin yoga class where we're gonna do 3-minute intervals of Tibetan bells. I do that every time. And they're going to go off in 3 minutes. Sometimes it might take us longer to get in the pose and we'll just hold it a little longer on both sides. So I'm doing this so you can listen to your own intuition and follow your own promptings of your heart while you're in these poses, and to surrender gradually becomes wonderful. So maybe right now it's tense, you just kind of breathe through the stuff that feels sticky or tight or annoying. Try to surrender and accept everything. Because it does get better, and it's life. Life can be sticky and stuck and annoying a lot. So if we learn here to breathe through the stuff and grow and change and show up and be present for the stuff that's uncomfortable, then hopefully we can use this practice to go outside of in our lives and breathe and surrender when it's uncomfortable and grow through it. Life will always give us opportunities for that. So today, a couple of blocks and a bolster. If you don't have a couple blocks or a bolster, it's okay. You can use, for many of these poses, you can use an old basketball or soccer ball that's somewhat deflated. You can use any kind of cushions, house pillows, or just maybe have a few different sizes handy so you can get where you need to go. And I had my 2 blocks here. Yes, 2 blocks are here. Good. Sorry. All right, let's do this. So we'll start waking up our toes first. So all of your toes, and you can see my toes, they're all on the ground. So even my pinky is kind of on the ground. And if we can start with a minor low-key inversion where our hips are a little higher, and maybe our head is on the mat. And our head is on the mat, so that way we're almost inverted, getting the benefits. And I'm gonna be silent now. Thank you. a giraffe position. It's like a pigeon where your knee is parallel to the front of the mat, and then your left foot is also at a 90 degree back foot from leg, front closer to the line. I'm going to actually put my leg on a mat, on a bolster. You can too if you want. Fold over the leg. Use the props you need until you don't need them. Roll onto the right hip. Stretch the left leg out. Continue to fold over the right leg. Thank you.
I'll straighten the right leg up when you're ready to do that. Press into your hands slowly. Come on up. Lie down on top of Alex. Feet up right underneath your knees. Shift both your knees to the left. Look over your right shoulder. Take your left foot on top of your right knee. Or not. bolster up luck under your legs. Toes are touching, knees are falling apart, feet in cobbler, reclined, goddess or cobbler pose. Heel toe your toes, feet under your knees, maybe a little bit outside of your hips, towards the edges of the mat, and then bring your knees together. If it bothers your knees, you can just point your knees straight to the ceiling. You still get a wonderful sacrum release, sacral attachment release. Yes, breathe. If you'd like a deeper stretch for your side, bunch of elbow. And the deepest stretch would be to come straight on both hands. This for another count of the bell if you prefer to find which level you want to stretch at. And breathe. Is a pillow for your head, and your armpit is, your hands are straight, reaching straight from your shoulder. Doesn't matter so much if your legs are bent or straight. Your elbow. Make sure your elbow's right underneath your shoulder. Lift, keep lifting your heart. Whichever level you feel the most stretch at, just stay there for another minute.
hands and knees.
Let's just step up into a ragdoll forward fold. Bend your knees as much as you need to and relax over your legs. And let your head go completely. Hold on to either elbow. You can sway. And then find stillness if you want. You can bounce. Child's pose. You can use a supportive child's pose or not. You can put a bolster right in front of you and just fold over your bolster. Maybe bring your arms down by your sides. To remain in child's pose, we can remove the block for a shoulder opener. So take the right arm, left arm reaches up. Thread the needle under the right arm. Place the left side of your head on the mat. Thank you. into the right hand. Left elbow on the ground. Right hand reaches up. Try it. Thread the needle. Come back to child's pose, resting the right side of the head on the mat.